like everything Inkling does is really fast and it gets out of range of me, so I can't really do much. Like I can't, like I parried
right
his aerial and I still couldn't.
Yep. So but, we have a Beegs and Eris here at PS2. This is game one, and
Eris has been coming here for a long time.
Yeah, he has. He has.
But I've never seen Beegs Marth before.
Yeah, he's been playing a little bit. He got a back air string from Eris early on, and now.
Now, do you think he'll use Cloud at all tonight, or do you think he'll only use that for like comfort choice with certain people?
Yeah, he's gonna really just be sticking with that Marth, just to flex him a bit, get him some more exposure, and then you'll kind of, when he's feeling the pressure, go back to Cloud. So let's see if Eris can do that, make him feel that pressure, and see where he goes. But right now, it's a pretty even match.
Just a lot of footsies back and forth.
Lots of footsies. Ooh, that would have been the call out there at the forward side on the edge guard.
Yeah, that would have been interesting.
That would have been good.
Okay, good.
Yeah, Thunder Jolt to cover the approach.
Probably should do more of those Thunder Jolts, since Marth doesn't really have a way to approach through that.
Agreed, agreed. If we get some Thunder Jolts, some runaway Thunder Jolt game, maybe that can create some space that Eris can do something with.
Yeah.
He can bird off of.
Interesting choice of it. That dash attack.
Don't want to give Marth space because lets him do the tippers and all the things that he does. So,
like that.
Speaking
yeah.
of, okay, there we go. Commentator's curse right there.
Yeah, that's like one of the weirdest tips I've ever seen because like it always scoops up from the bottom.
It does, it does.
Ooh.
That was a good spike though by Eris. Just to call it on the counter. Good punish.
All right.
Okay,
trading.
Okay, he's in the Thunder Jolts. Maybe he's hearing our commentary.
All right.
Oh, got a string here. Ooh. Oh, this is good.
Did he keep his jump? I hope he can.
Oh, wow. That is a good gimp.
Thunder shot.
Just called him out on it.
Man, using dancing blades on the shield. Still hasn't caught onto that very well, but.
No, it's quite punishable if he just goes for it. And he rigged up their back air string again. Let's see what happens.
Getting a little nervous, but he made it back regardless.
He did. The forward smash was quite a call on Eris' part, but he was just trying to shut this match down pretty quickly.
Yeah. Good patience from Eris.
Yeah, agreed.
He's gotten a lot more patient than he was before.
Ooh, that was a good nair, though. Oh, shoot.
Right.
Okay, well, Eris is back on stage. Let's see what happens here.
87 damage with Marth. Anything can happen here. He gets one good hit. Like that. Like that.
There it is. There it is. The commentator's curse again. We are unbiased commentators. This is not any favoritism whatsoever. It happens to be that tippers are happening when we talk about them.
Yeah. Tippers are fun.
Oh.
Ooh, that would have been something.
That was a call out right there for sure.
Tipper down smash.
Wow. Just a few hits and Beegs is almost evening us up.
Okay, good back throw. Oh, it didn't reverse it.
Oh, this is not good.
Oh, it didn't capitalize.
That fastball just really called put a timer on that forward smash.
No, but there's that dash attack. Surprisingly strong.
Ooh.
Oh,
spike.
Gosh. Oh. Lots of flubs all over the place.
This is anyone's game right now.
Oh. Okay, Beak's not using it.
He's got to be careful. There's the call.
Wow.
That was a good forward smash. Eris takes game one, so we'll see what Beegs does here. If he's going to stay Marth or if he's going to hop off.
Yeah, I think Beegs was trying to read some kind of approach from Eris there, but no approach.
He just got called out on it completely.
All right. Ooh. Huh.
So let's see. PS2. Oh, is he just going to run it back? Jeez. Okay. He's going to run it back, and he is going Cloud. Okay.
Yeah, there it is.
So comfort choice. Getting scared off. 1-0 Eris right now.
Yeah.
I will see. He's bringing out the Cloud. He's got the sweater vest on, so he's ready to go.
He uses the blue Cloud from Advent.
You know, really, Cloud just has different shades of black.
Yeah, that's what my friends always make fun of.
He's just that edgy. Okay, so we got a... We got some cross slash calls big time, and Beegs really likes to do these anti-airs of the cross slashes.
Yeah.
So really got to be careful of these things. He
There's
will
those
call you up strings.
Thunder Jolt's probably going to be a lot better than whatever Blade Beam he would decide to try to challenge it with. But...
Yeah, it's a matter of how is Eris going to create space here.
Or force Beegs to approach, because Beegs is trying to be patient.
play it.
It is definitely a balance, because if Aeris plays it too campy, then Cloud can just charge a limit. So
yeah,
he's gotta ride that line.
This forward tilt.
Didn't expect it to reach.
With Thunder Jolts covering that platform. There's those cross slash call outs again. And then what Beegs is gonna be doing here is anytime he has advantage, he's gonna try to build that limit meter, and as we kind of see here. So he's got this advantage state, and he's gonna be keep calling this limit out.
Yeah.
But Aeris just needs to get back to center stage and hope he can make something of it.
Oh, all right. Good forward air falling right on top.
Biggs has that edge game pretty good. He creates that pressure and just scares you.
Just throwing out that quick 38.
Yep. Limit cross slash is what it does. Oh, good call out by Aeris. Good forward smash.
All right. Trying to get a ledge jump, I think. But...
yeah, he then just gave up stage there. It's a risky maneuver.
Good Nair.
Here comes the quick attack. Ooh.
I'm surprised that Nair's hitting so much after what they did to it.
Yep, exactly. Actually, what Beegs will do is he'll intentionally reverse it because the back hit of it has a better hitbox than the front of it.
Yeah.
Hashtag cloud problems. Ooh. Let's see what's going to happen with this limit here. Aeris should really just try to run away at this point. Just time him out. And he's
I
doing a good job of
that.
I
thought that was a mistake.
The blade beam?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it might have been.
Maybe it was some kind of weird buffer after getting hit by that Thunder Jolt.
Maybe he was hoping Aeris would do a landing Thunder Jolt and just catch him.
Yeah, maybe.
But who knows?
Because it would have probably killed.
Oh, for sure. Question is, what's going to happen? Oh, the call out. That up B recovery that he does there with the Crime Hazard, that is that's pretty safe. So,
ooh, yeah.
Another good forward smash by Aeris.
Though if Aeris catches it with something, I bet he's got something that can probably challenge it.
Yep, and Beegs has the answer back with the back air on the ledge.
I feel like his best options would probably be a forward smash to kind of counter that up B, but or just fall off and do a thunder.
Yeah, he could. It's very quick though, so it's kind of a risky maneuver. I don't know if he wants to try to risk that right now, but
yeah,
he is up a game, but he's also down a stock. Oh boy, limit just online. See what happens here.
Climbing that damage.
Yep. The tricky part is just Cloud's weight changes too, so
yeah,
the combo timing on Pikachu's part just it gets a little different.
Definitely. But we got some strings followed by a string of his own.
What do we got going on? And there is get back to center. Ooh, this is risky. Ooh. I was expecting a grab there by Cloud.
Good down air, but nothing capitalized off it. Let go of shield way too early.
These quick attacks. Aeris is living life on the edge.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, wow. That
was a call out on the roll for sure. My goodness. Okay, so that's even set right now. 1-1. We'll see where Aeris goes on his counter pick. Any thoughts? Where he might go on this one? Thinking they run it back again or?
I'm not sure. Achievement.
Yep.
I don't know if Aeris really cares too much about stage pick, but I guess he thinks town and city is gonna do him some good. Maybe open area, get a lot of space away from Cloud.
Yeah. Going Palu. Okay. Well, he probably doesn't want to give Cloud a wall jump, so he probably doesn't want to go Kalos or Story.
Yeah.
Just because it helps Cloud's recovery. So we'll see where we end up. Okay.
From what I remember seeing, I would have probably stuck with Pikachu because he's a lot more comfortable with him, but. I don't know. Maybe he's got some new tech with this Palutena.
I actually don't know what Beast's experience here is the Palu matchup, but we'll see.
I know, considering I use Icon, it's kind of sort of similar. Not really, but the Palutena matchup, her Nair can catch almost everything.
Right. Yeah, exactly.
Her
Nair
does.
Is gross.
Yeah.
So let's see what Aeris decides to do with this.
We're also looking at those back airs and dash attacks with the shield armor going on.
Yeah, Beegs is really playing the safe, just trying to create as much distance between him and Palutena as possible so she cannot ride that Nair train.
Questionable.
Oh boy, there's the call out.
Now watch this drive.
That we call out the PGA right there. That's Okay, Aeris is looking like he's a little scared right now. So momentum is definitely in Beegs' favor. See if he can turn that around.
I definitely know that usually Aeris, when he gets a little frustrated when it comes to like getting behind with Palutena, he'll try to throw out a lot of ranged attacks trying to force the other person in. So I wonder if he'll start doing that in a second.
Well, here comes the limit charge. So if he's going to start camping, then B Deegs is going to answer back by charging that limit and getting those very potent kill options. Oh, here we go.
Oh, wow.
Finishing touch just calls him out on it. That's the thing he's going to be just wearing on. You can't camp all day. Cloud does have a means to charge that limit.
All right. Okay. Very punishable. Sort
that was a good punish.
That was a good up tilt. That's my favorite Palutena move, is that up tilt. It's so good. But the pressure is not stopping for poor old Eris here.
Yeah, there is quite a stock lead, so we're probably going to see some bold decisions coming from Beeg to try to shut this match out.
All right, so...
limit's up, so be wary. That was very good.
I wonder if he didn't have limit. I wonder if he would have got KO'd, since he would have been a little light.
Yeah, that weight change.
Oop, got the short one, didn't call it.
Good jump. Playing it safe. That was a greedy check right there, and Eris is playing it patient, so that was good on his part.
Ooh, that caught him out of the roll.
Oh man, the call out on the up B.
Yeah, Eris keeps using his jump way too early.
Can he get back to center? This is the hard part. No.
Ooh, that nair. All right.
That's a nair kill by Cloud, and you don't see those very often.
No. That or cross slashing.
Right. So two.